back of the cinema where he's actually performing, so that's really cool. And yeah, I'm gonna sit again, and she's like so excited for this. So now we're just gonna go for a walk around, I don't know, take a couple photos or something, and yeah, should be good. You can't keep borrowing my heart. Walking around, waiting for the concert to start, because it doesn't start till 7:30 and it's like 6:45 or something. So yeah, we're just walking, but yeah, so catch you later. Okay guys, so we're in the venue and the music's playing, but Taylor's not here yet, and Crystal's so excited. So excited. So yeah, and they were just playing Nile. Oh my god. Yeah. So I hope it's good. This is kind of what the stage looks like. That's what the stage looks like, but it should be fun. That's not him.
Listen to I, the baby. refunds are unavailable. So just have to deal with
I'll
it.
I'll just take a good time.
But you guys can decide whether I sound like this guy or not, okay? So I'll leave it up to you, alright?
We'll do a poll after the show on Instagram.
Yes.
Just a poll.
It'll be like 100% yes.
Won't let you go.
love you, what do you do when you love somebody and they don't love you back?
What's up, and I am back from the concert, and oh my god, I met Taylor Henderson. I am so in shock that I even like met him. I don't know, I'm shocked. Like, I don't even know what to say. Like, I have no words. Like, I never thought in a million years that I would actually see Taylor Henderson like perform, but also meet him, because we never got the VIP ticket, so we just thought that we wouldn't meet him and it would just be all over. But we actually met Taylor, guys. Like I actually met Taylor. Like, that's crazy. Like, because he said after the show, he's like, okay guys, I want to meet some of you, if that's okay. And then we lined up and we got like tickets, and I mean not tickets, we got like our stuff like signed and everything, which I'll show you guys right here. And our ticket sign and stuff. And oh my god, and I gave him a hug and everything like that. I will do a story time because it's like really late. We just got home. It's like 11 o'clock. So, you know. But we're going to like, I'll do a whole story time to this in my next video, because I want this to be a vlog and then like a story time. Or like, I'll put like a pull up on Instagram what you guys want. And then, like, you can just write from there. But, yeah, like, I'm so, like, I cannot believe I actually met Taylor. Like, I'm, like, I like when I was lining up to meet him, I was, like, so in shock. Because my heart was, like, pounding. And the lady was like, you looked a bit stunned there. Like, just, like, it's okay. And I'm like, it's not okay meeting Taylor. Like, I don't know. Like, guys, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say. Like, I think my life's complete. I honestly thought I died there and then, but I haven't. Like, I'm living, like, oh my god. And I just want to say to you, all of you out there who have not yet met your celebrities or your idols, the day it will come. Just trust me. Like, it will come. If you believe in so much of it, even if it's not your favorite idol, but it's one of your celebrities that you admire so much, believe in yourself that you will meet them one day, because of course it's going to come true. Like, I guess it could come true. I can't really guarantee it on you guys, but just believe in yourself. And if you do that, then you are going to be the best person that you have ever been. So, yeah. I can't, like, I still can't believe it that I've actually met him. Like, I'm crazy. Like, that's crazy. Like, so crazy. Like, oh my god, guys. Like, I can't even deal. And then he sung Host of Angels, and I literally lost it, guys. I lost it. I cried my eyeballs out, because that song means so much to me. Like, it's such a song that means so much to me. And I've never ever cried really at a concert before like that, where, well, it's kind of like a gig, but like where I just like did that, but like cried in that song. But yeah, and my sister is here.
Hi.
And she got her arm signed, Joanne. Oh my god. God, like, I can't deal with this, guys. And also, I didn't show you before, but this is what I wear to the concert, or like the gig, basically. So I just wore like my crop top, my shorts, and my old Converse. But my top is from City Beach, my shorts are from Zara, and my Converse are just from City Beach as well. So yeah, but that's all, guys, and I'm gonna end the vlog here. And yeah, I will do a story time. And yeah, so please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye! Hey guys, what's up? And I am back from the concert. It's actually been a couple days after the concert, but so yeah, I got you guys to vote on Instagram if you wanted the story time and the vlog in one video or in separate videos, and you guys decided on the one video, so that's what I'm giving you guys. So yeah, so I feel like I have to do a story time to this, because I cannot like, I still could not believe that I actually met Taylor Henderson, and it's crazy. So I thought I have to give you guys story time, because all this happened so quickly in the week, because I didn't even know that I was going to the concert until like that week before, like a couple days before it. So I thought I'd give you guys a whole story time on it. And yeah, and before we do get into it, if you don't know who Taylor Henderson is, he was actually a contestant on X Factor in Australia, and he got to the actual finals. And if you guys know who Dami Im is, she's the one who won the X Factor, but Taylor was in that season, which was 2013, I'm pretty sure he auditioned for. Yeah, 2013, and he was also, he came second, and then Jai Whiteford, he came third. So he was in that category season of the X Factor. So, and he also auditioned, I think it was for Australia's Got Talent before the X Factor with his dad, and they wanted him, but not his dad, I think. That's how it works, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, so anyway, Taylor Henderson is a contestant from X Factor who came second on the X Factor, if you guys were wondering, and you should go check him out because he's really, really cool, and I really love his music. So yeah, if you guys don't know who Taylor Henderson is, then yeah, just thought I'd give you that info if you want to check him out. But yeah, so anyway, so let's get back to the story time. So what happened was, is that me and my friend, we went up to Grafton because I live like 43 minutes or an hour away from this city slash town named Grafton, and that's where Taylor was performing. So I went up with her shopping in the week, and I knew from last year that he was coming to Grafton, but then I completely forgot. So as we're walking down the main street, as this, we went past the cinema, or well, the Sheraton Theatre where he was performing, so that's like the venue where Taylor was performing. Anyway, so we went past and I saw the posters up, and I also saw posters up back in like shop windows advertising Taylor Henderson's coming to Grafton. Oh my god, because not many people actually come to this town to really perform that's well known. So I was like, oh my god, we have to go, but my friend obviously couldn't make it because of work and stuff. So when I came back from work, I asked my dad and I asked my sister, Taylor Henderson is coming to Grafton, we have to go, like, this is a no-brainer, we have to go, I have to see Taylor. So anyway, and my sister was just excited as much as I was to go see him, so yeah. But anyway, so we got there, and I booked the tickets through the week, and then on the 19th, which was a Saturday, we went there to see Taylor. So we got up to Grafton like early, not too early, but early enough so we could have some food before the concert and whatnot. So we got there, and then after we had dinner, we just went straight to the venue, and then because we're still pretty early, we just went for a walk around the main street or whatnot, just to like kill some time or whatever. And then we got back, and then we waited 10 minutes, and then 20 past, because the concert started at 7:30. They opened the doors like 20 minutes past 7, so yeah. So anyway, when they opened the doors, we went in, and as we went in, Taylor had no opening, like he wasn't, no one was opening for him, it was just him and his keyboard player named Josh. So I'd insert like a photo of me here or here, which was like my second photo on Instagram. So we went in there, and then we sat there waiting for Taylor to come on. As we went in the venue, Niall Horan was playing. They were playing Niall Horan. So I thought, after that, I thought, this is going to be a good night. This is like, it's going to be one of those nights to remember. And pretty much any concert night really is one of those nights to remember. So yeah, anyway, so it was a good night as well. So after that, we waited for Taylor to come on. Obviously Taylor came on, and I was just so in shock. I mean, I cannot believe that he was actually standing right in front of me, because it is absolutely crazy. I mean, I cannot believe Taylor Henderson was standing right in front of me on stage. And there weren't actually that many people there either. There was like, it was literally like half full. Like, the cinema, or the, well, the theatre, sorry guys, the theatre was half full. So on the ground floor, and then you have a top floor, and it was only the ground floor, and half the ground floor was, that was all who showed up. So there was like tons of people here, and then because I booked tickets, a seat back, it felt like that these seats in front of us were booked, but I wasn't sure because I felt, I feel like just people booked their tickets, but then they just didn't turn up to the show or whatnot. So anyway, so we were like here, and the theatre's pretty small too, guys, as you would see in the vlog, like where we're sitting, we're pretty close. So, it was there, so the people were there, like tons of people were there near the stage, and then there were seats there, and then we were here, and then there were other people right at the back of us. So, I mean, we were pretty easy to see. So, and my sister was the first person for Taylor to wave to her, and she was so excited because he was also singing a song called Piece by Piece, and that's one of her favorite songs. So, yeah, so he waved to her, and she got pretty excited about that. So, yeah, that was pretty awesome for her. And then he also waved to me too in the concert as well, throughout the concert, and other people as well, like, of course. He waved to people, and I was just so excited. And then he also sung Host of Angels. And Host of Angels is one of my favorite songs. It means so much to me. So when I heard it live, I bawled my eyes out because it's a very meaningful song. And he's like, if you're going through anything, just sing this out. Just sing it out. Just cry. Just sing. I was like, oh my God, like, I can't actually believe, like, it's the first time ever that I've ever cried at a concert before. Like, the first time ever I've actually bawled my eyes out in a song at a concert. So I was like, I couldn't believe it, that I couldn't believe that, like, I cried. Anyway, but I did, and I was so happy. But anyway, as well as crying at the same time, but I was so happy because that song means so much to me. So then he sung more songs and in more of his singles, and as the concert went on, he was like seeing us dance too. It was like so amazing. But anyway, so after the concert ended, before he sung his last song, he's like, okay guys, after this I would like to meet some of you if that's okay. And now, because me and my sister didn't get VIP tickets, because we thought that we had to get VIP tickets to see Taylor Henderson, we didn't, so we just thought we'd go see the show. Anyway, little did we know that he was doing a meet and greet after the show. So before he sung his last song, he's like, hey guys, after the show, I'd like to meet some of you guys. And I was like, oh my God, we are actually meeting Taylor Henderson. Like, this is crazy. Like, I cannot believe this is happening right now. Like, what the hell? Like, oh my God. So anyway, so we, as the concert finished, we went out into the other room, and we thought he would come out there, but he didn't. So we had to go back into the theater. And anyway, and then the lady said, oh, he won't be too long, guys. He's just, like, you know, finishing up. So, and then he came out, and then we're in the merch line, and then Josh was coming down, which is the keyboard player. He was coming down and just speaking to every one of us, just to keep us entertained and starting conversations. So we got hugs and pictures with him. And yeah, so that's what happened. And as we got close to the line, we were standing there waiting to meet Taylor. And Taylor's just there, like, chilling. And he is just looking at me and my sister. And I'm just, like, looking at him, and I'm, like, breathing. And I'm like, oh my God, okay, we're meeting Taylor, oh my God. And my sister went first, so I took her photo and whatnot. And she also got her arm signed, and she also gave him a kiss on the cheek, which was really cute. And so anyway, so as I was waiting to go, she's like, the lady's like, you look a bit stunned there, love. And she's like, it's okay. And I'm like, in my head, I was like, no, it's not. Like, Taylor Henderson is right there in front of me, and I don't even know what to do. Like, oh my God, like, I cannot believe that I'm actually about to meet Taylor. And he's like, just looking at me, and he's like, hi, how are you? And I was like, oh my God, like, I really can't believe, I'm sorry, guys. I really cannot believe that I actually saw Taylor Henderson, like, actually met Taylor Henderson. Like, what the hell? Like, that just doesn't happen. So he was like, hey, how are you? I was like, I'm good, how are you? I was like, at that point in time, you don't really know what to say. You just, you're in the moment and you just say whatever. And the one question I wanted to ask him is if I should audition for the X Factor. So I asked him that and he's like, honestly, I don't think what they're doing it anymore. And I was like, what, any like TV show like Britain's Got Talent or whatever? And he's like, honestly, I don't know, but if you have the confidence enough and if you believe in yourself enough, then go for it. So I really couldn't believe that, like, which is true. I think I should need to like believe in myself a little bit more with things, and that's what you need to do if you want to go do something that you want to do. Believe in yourself and you can do it. So that's what I think is so true of what he told me. And anyway, so he gave me a hug, we got a photo, and which I'll insert right here or here. And yeah, and then after I got a photo, we started to head off after he signed our stuff, which I'll show you guys. Okay, so this is the stuff he signed, which was our poster and our ticket down there, which is the ticket, the writing's on the back, but he signed the back of it. So I have framed it already, but yeah, so that's that. And yeah, so anyway, so as we were leaving, I was like, no, I have to get one more hug from Taylor. Like, I cannot leave without another hug from Taylor. And because my sister was kissing him on the cheek, I'm not actually sure, but I just went in for a hug because I like hugs. So I gave him a hug. As I gave him a hug, he kissed me briefly on the cheek and I was not ready for it. And I was like, oh my God, like, he just like, oh my God, like, Taylor Henderson just kissed me on the cheek. Like, what the hell? So anyway, so that happened and I was like, oh my God, like, at that point I had no idea what to do. I was just so happy. I really enjoyed the show. I could not believe that I actually met Taylor Henderson. Like, it was crazy. And he's so nice, guys. He is so nice. I cannot believe that I just met Taylor Henderson, and that it's absolutely crazy. Like, I'm so thankful for that. So yeah, but anyway, that's pretty much the story time, guys. I just also want to say, I did say this in my vlog before, but make sure you believe in yourself enough, because if you have, guys, if you haven't met your idols yet, it will happen, guys. Okay, you just have to believe in yourself enough, and I can't guarantee that it will completely happen, but I guess, I mean, I don't know, guys. Like, I've never thought that I'd actually get to meet one of my idols, so but I believed in myself enough, like, to be able to be like, okay, one day I will meet them. When and where, I'm not sure, but it will happen. And guys, it will happen. Just have faith. Just believe in yourself. And if you do, that can be the best person you guys can be, because I believe in you. And yeah, basically, so just believe in yourself and anything can happen for you, guys. Just stay positive, because you will meet your idol one day. You will. It will happen. Okay, guys? It will happen. Okay? So, yeah. But anyway, that's all I wanted to say to you guys. I really hope you enjoyed this vlog / story time. I just didn't want it to be too long. So, yeah. But anyway, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to follow all my social medias down in the... which are always down in the description box below. So yeah, so go make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.